So I wanted to do a little unboxing of these cameras, the Easy View cameras that we use here. So I'm gonna open these up. I just got these today, so let's see what I've got here. So I ended up getting three of them because it was Prime Day, and figured, hey, why not save a little cash on some cameras? So this is the Easy View C3N. So it's a Wi-Fi camera. It just takes power and a micro SD card and connects to your Wi-Fi. You can view it remotely. So let's just unbox this and see what we got going on. And I want to share with you, and then I'll share with you the what the video looks like and how you can view it remotely and all that good stuff. So it's packed really well. There you go. It comes with a nice little booklet, instructions, also known as packing material. We don't use that. But here's the camera. So that's all there is to it. It's fairly weighty because it's got a good metal housing, nice and protected on the screen. To get to the SD card, you just open up this with a small screwdriver. Does not come with an SD card, so that's something else you'd have to purchase. But it does come with a little 12 volt power adapter. Now what I do is, because I have a number of these cameras, I actually have some connectors that I hook to a regular 12 volt power supply so I can run longer wire runs. So if I'm going from one corner of the house to the other corner of the house and I need more than the 4 feet of cable that comes with it, I can just do it that way. But all you have to do is put in your SD card here, plug it in. Once it's plugged in, you get some power lights, and it's not plugged in now, obviously. You get some power lights, and then you can initialize the SD card, and you're up and running. So let's walk through that. Okay, so we've got our camera. We're going to flip it over, and we're going to put the SD card in. And I actually grabbed the right side of my little screwdriver. There's a couple little Phillips screws, little size 0 Phillips screws. You pop those off. And not quite enough. There you go. Nice thing about these two, this little housing as well, is it's waterproof. There's a little silicone seal around this spot on the door. I don't know if you can see it real well, but there's a silicone seal that plugs in here to the reset button connecting to this side, and it's all silicone, so it's all sealed. So once you have this door screwed back on there, you're good to go. So I like to use as big of a micro SD card as I've got, just for retrieval of video. This one's 128 gigabytes. I've got a 256, but not handy. So I'm just gonna insert the card, and I always forget which way to do this, but it'll tell you if it's wrong or not. So there we go, that goes in, clicks it in, and we put the door back on. Just reverse the process of taking the door off. If you've never taken a door on and off with a screwdriver, I'm sure this is exciting, otherwise pretty boring. So I like to make sure that my screws are nice and tight so that I keep that that water tightness. That's good. That's good. Now what we'll do is we'll get this thing plugged in. So I got my, it's all initialized, all the SD cards all in there. So we'll get this thing initialized, and we'll show you how that process works. All right, so I went and I grabbed an extension cord. I'm gonna plug in the camera, and as soon as you do, you'll see some lights come on. You should see the red LED come on. And then the way that you enroll this camera into your system, once you download the Easy VIZ app, so I'm gonna open up my camera and get my app open. It's pretty easy to do, but what you do, so you got your Easy View app loading up. So there's my existing cameras that I have there now. So I'm going to add a camera. So you click the little plus, add a device. It's a camera. And then there's a little spot here where you can scan a QR code, which there happens to be a QR code. There it is. It's on the base. Really small, but you can kind of see. I'm going to try to, there we go. So it's adding the device. That's the serial number. It's asking me, is the device powered on? Yes, it's powered on. Making sure that it's connecting. So I'm going to start that process. And it's telling you to look to make sure, see if the light is flashing blue. It is, which means it's connecting. So I'm going to connect it to the network. Connecting it. I want to connect it. Connecting, plus the app. Still flashing blue, which means it's connecting. So it takes a minute or so, but we'll see what happens here. So what's happening right now is that it's connecting to my camera. So now it wants me to name it. So I'm just going to call it Spare One. Next. There you go. So I'm naming the camera. And then we're going to place it someplace. So I'm going to set my phone down while I place the camera looking out the window. So now you can kind of see looking out the window here. And we're good. So we don't want audio on. Time zone, daylight savings. Turn that off because we don't do daylight savings. I'm here in Arizona. So we're doing month, day, year. We're good there. Hit next. And then I don't want to change the encryption password, so it's asking me to create one. Okay, so I've got my camera set up, so I'm gonna skip the free trial. So here's what the videos look like. So there's the device that I just did. So I need to initialize the SD card before we can use it. So before you can start recording. So you hit initialize. Gonna format it. It's going to format that. Memory card, it's doing its format thing. So the one thing that it did ask me to do was to change the password on the device. So if you want to go in and change any of the settings, you need to have a new password. So I did that. I'm not going to share what my password is because I don't want anybody coming in, connecting to my camera and changing my password back. That's the one thing that I skipped in this video as far as changing my password. So I just didn't want you to see my password that I typed in. Okay. All right. So we have normal memory card. So there we go. Now what we can do is we can look at, there's my footage. Now one cool thing too you can do is you can turn your phone and you get full screen of what you see on your from your camera. The reason it looks all grainy or pixely, not pixely, but all these little squares, it's because it's looking through my screen on my out my window. So if I go back and look at some of my other cameras, like here's my front door. So if I pull up my front door, it doesn't look like that because it's not looking through a screen. It's actually mounted on the outside of my house. So if I wanted to pull up and see what's going on, one of the nice things too about these cameras is you see this motion over here, it's actually going to record pretty much constantly because of this tree. What I need to do is move this camera a little bit further down the wall to the front door so I don't get this movement from the tree, because they have motion detection built into the camera. So if I look and I want to look at, so here's the front door. This one isn't recording right now because this is looking right out my front yard. You can see there's a storm brewing to the south of us because this is looking kind of towards the south at the gate. But it's not recording right now because it's not picking up any of the movement. So if I want to go back and look at today at 12:40, I can hit play. And I don't know if you can see on there, but it was raining. So I picked up the movement from the rain on that video. So that's kind of what's cool about this app, is that no matter where I am, I can pull up and go back. If I wanted to look at the calendar, let me go hit the calendar button, and I can look and see how far back. So the bigger the video card, the further back you can go, because it'll just write over. So if I wanted to see what happened on the 4th of July at, so it's 4 o'clock in the morning. Let's see, at 1:30 in the afternoon, that's what's happening in my front yard at 1:30 in the afternoon on the 4th of July. nothing, but it was a beautiful day. So you can kind of see where it picked up some of the movement of these trees. You can't really change the sensitivity easily, but I do like that I can remotely view these cameras from anywhere. It's pretty awesome. If there was something that I know that had happened, I can pull up by whatever date, wherever it was. The reason I have doing this video today is because I'm gonna put some more cameras around the house. I'm gonna put some cameras in the house just so I can see what's going on. The cameras mount. They have three screws. They mount flush to the wall. There's a indentation on the base so that you can put. So if you look here, if you're mounting, so you have the cable sticking through. It also does power over Ethernet. So if you have a PoE system to power these cameras, you can use that. I just find the 12 volt system a lot easier to work with because one, I don't have a PoE system. Another cool feature of these cameras is they've actually got night vision as well. They've got infrared lighting on the camera, so it'll see out a little way. So here's looking again out my front door. So I'm going to pull up some footage that was obviously that was at night. So here's 5 in the morning, 4 in the morning, 2 o'clock in the morning, my front door early this morning. So there's what you can see. This is what happened in my house 2 o'clock in the morning. There's a little bug. So that's what triggered the motion sensor. It looks like a spider. That's what triggered the motion sensor to start recording at 2 o'clock in the morning. So you can see it also does a little timestamp down here. I'm going to try to bring it a little bit closer. So 7/13/2022 at 2:16 in the morning. And it does a nice little timestamp on here. But you can see it, the IR throws out pretty good. So if somebody were to walk up to my front door over here, I'd be able to see who it was. So until I move the camera closer, I'm not going to be able to see who it was real clear, just that there was somebody that came up to my front door. So, but it will at nighttime pick up the bugs that are flying around, especially if you have the cameras outside. So just kind of a fun little fact. So that's what's going on with the night vision. So here you see at 4:58, when it started to get light, it kicked on again because of it getting lighter, and then it turns to color. So if you wanted to turn on the camera for night vision to be color like this, you can actually go in. I got to get out of the playback. You can go into the settings and you can see night vision mode, black and white night vision, or you can have it color. But what it does is it's actually going to put out a light. It'll turn on two little LED lights on the front of the camera, so you'll see color. But my opinion is that's also going to alert somebody to, hey, there's a camera here. You've got the smart night vision as well, where when motion is detected, it turns on a light and switches to color. But I would rather have somebody not realize that those cameras are there and not record in color at nighttime. It's not that big of a deal to me, but that's just another one of these, one of the cool features. It comes with everything you need. So it's got everything but the SD card. It does come with some mounting hardware. It's got some screws. It's got some anchors. So if you were mounting it in something hollow, it's got everything you need. These cameras are great. I can't say enough good things about them. So I'll put a link to where you can buy your camera, your EZ-VIZ camera below. And if you have any questions, put it in the comments below. And thanks for watching.